Later in the course, you're going to build out a sample web application that uses an Elastic Load Balancer. To encrypt traffic between the load balancer and the client, we're going to need a Transport Layer Security, or TLS, certificate. People often call this a Secure Sockets Layer, or SSL, certificate, but SSL hasn't been used for over 10 years, and what they really mean is TLS. Anyway, the Amazon Certificate Manager, ACM, makes it super easy to create a certificate for multiple domain names. However, before ACM will issue a certificate, you must prove that you control the DNS records for the domain. So the first order of business is to have a domain name. Now, you may already have a domain name that you want to use, and that's fine. You can use it, no problem. But if you don't, Route 53, Amazon's DNS service, makes it really easy to register one. In this demo, I'm going to show you what you need DNS-wise to get a TLS certificate using ACM. We'll briefly look at where you can register a domain name in Route 53, but I'm not going to bore you with the details of the domain registration process, which is self-explanatory. Next, we're going to actually request a TLS certificate from ACM. Let's jump over to the Route 53 Service Console. In the Route 53 Service Console, on the navigation menu, please click on Register Domains. If you want to register a domain name, just click Register Domain right up here, and then follow the process. For example, let's say I want to register coastalcarolinanetworks.com. I go and type that in, and then I can click Check. And it tells me that it's unavailable. That's because I already have it. Like I said, it's self-explanatory. You certainly do not need my help to do this. I already have a domain name I want to use for the certificate, which again is this coastalcarolinanetworks.com. When you register a domain name using Route 53, it creates what's called a public hosted zone. So let's go ahead and click Cancel here. And on the navigation menu, please click Hosted Zones. A public hosted zone is simply where DNS records for the domain are stored. You can see here I have one for coastalcarolinanetworks.com. When it comes to getting a TLS certificate, what's important here is that I control the domain name and I control the DNS records. So this all looks good, and that means we are ready to request a TLS certificate. Let's jump over, please, to the ACM Service Console. In the ACM Service Console, click the Request a Certificate button. Because we're going to be using this certificate with an internet-facing load balancer, we need this to be a public certificate. So we're going to request a public certificate, click Next. Next, it asks us what domain names we want the certificate for. Now, what I like to do here is put the domain name all by itself, coastalcarolinanetworks.com, and then I click Add Another Name to this certificate. And to make this easy, I'm going to go ahead and copy this to my clipboard, and I'm going to do star.coastalcarolinanetworks.com. Okay, why am I doing this? Well, let's say that I want this certificate to be valid for www.coastalcarolinanetworks.com. That asterisk is going to make this a wildcard certificate, so it's going to be valid for any subdomain like www. Without the wildcard, the TLS certificate would be valid only for coastalcarolinanetworks.com and nothing else. So this is just going to give me some flexibility in how I use the certificate. And by the way, if you have multiple different domain names you want to use, you can specify those as well. But the same rule applies. You have to control the DNS records for any domains you add to the certificate. Now, if I scroll down a little bit, it asks us to select a validation method, DNS or email validation. I always do DNS validation because it's a little more foolproof than email validation because emails can get caught in spam filters and whatnot. So we'll stick with DNS validation, scroll down a little bit, and click Request. Now, you may have to wait a few seconds and hit refresh several times, but the certificate status should change to issued. Because I'm using Route 53, it automatically created the validation records for me. Once ACM validates the domain, it issues the certificate. Once you see that your certificate has been issued, you're good to go. Now, by the way, if you are not using Route 53, then you'll need to click on the certificate ID right over here. And under domains here, it tells us what records you need to create with your DNS provider. In this case, there are two CNAME records, one for each domain, the base domain and the wildcard domain. Once you create those records, it can take several minutes for ACM to pick them up, but once it does, AWS will automatically issue your certificate. All right, we are going to use the certificate a bit later in the course, but for now, let's wrap up this lesson.